So now we want to get started loading data into RStudio. And the first thing we actually want to do before we're loading data in is to figure out what our working directory is so that we can figure out how to load in files. So to do this, we can just do git wd and then open and close parentheses, and we can run that. And so you can see that this is the directory that I'm in. I'm just in my documents directory. Anything within my documents directory doesn't actually need a path, but anything outside my documents directory does actually need a path that we're going to give it. So what I'm actually going to do is actually go into a set working directory. So I'm going to go up to my session up here, and I'm going to say set working directory, and I'm going to go to choose directory. And so I'm just going to create a new folder in here called our tutorial, and I'm going to open this up, and that is going to set the working directory to that specific folder now. So now I'm in a little bit of a different folder. And if I come over to my files now, you see that this is also in this directory and that current folder is empty. And you can see in here, this is that actual file folder in there. And so what I really want to do is get some of this data that I downloaded. So I'm going to copy this CSV file and paste it over here. So now if I come back over here, and this doesn't automatically refresh, so sometimes you have to click here to refresh, this file is in this files list, but it is not an environment variable. So what we need to do is actually load this into our environment, and this is a CSV file. So the formula we're going to use for a CSV file is read.csv, and then in quotations, we can put the file name. So I'm gonna put population --demography.csv, and I'm gonna run it. And you can see that it printed it out here. But nothing really changed up here. And that's something really important is even though it read in the file, it did not actually set it to any variable. So every time I do anything, I'm gonna have to reread in this file. So the next thing we wanna do is actually set it to a variable. So I'm just gonna run this as df. Df often stands for data frame. It's a really generic name. As you start developing out your data analysis, you're going to wanna come up with variables that someone who did not write the code can actually read and understand what it is. For right now, I'm gonna use df, and then I'm gonna put in that same code. So read.csv. And then I'm just going to enter in the name again, population--demography.csv, and I can run it. So now you can see the change. Now we have a DF up here, and we can click on it and open it and see what's going on. And so this is just some data I got from Our World in Data. And so it's just the population by country and year. Sometimes we don't actually want to bring in data into here. So what I'm going to do real quick is I'm going to go in here. This is that folder that our current working directory is set to, and I'm actually going to delete it out. And so now I'm going to try and rerun this command right here. I'm just going to copy and paste it, and we're going to get an error because it doesn't exist there. But this file actually still exists in this R data in my downloads folder. So what I'm actually going to do here is right click, and I'm going to click copy as path. And then what we can do is I'm going to do git wd again, git working directory. And this gives me the formula that R is reading working directories in. So if I do df1, so I'm going to set it to a new variable name. I'm going to do read.csv. And in parentheses, I'm going to copy or paste this file path that I got from my actual folders. You can see one key difference between the working directory and what I just pasted. And that is essentially that all of these are backslashes and R reads it as forward slashes. So if I run this, I'm going to get an error because it doesn't understand this is escaping this character. It doesn't understand what I'm asking it for. So instead, I'm going to copy and paste this again, and I'm just going to remove these extra quotation marks here. And then what I need to do is convert all of these to whatever style it is in the Git working directory. So these should all be forward slashes instead of backslashes. And then I can run that. And now you see it populates in DF1. Even though this is not within our working directory, we can still put it in as long as we have the full file path for that file. And now we can do things like read it. So we can do head DF, and that's going to print out the first 6 rows of our data frame for us. So that is how we can now import in CSV files and set it to a variable. So now we can do things with the data.